by Free Knowledge Radio with another Truth Hour. Check this out. Boom.
WKIP, where knowledge is power.
Reverse racism, that is not reverse discrimination, that is the slave getting out from under the yoke of bondage and oppression. So you're nothing but hypocrites, and you won't pull that small time stuff over me.
How we doing? How we doing now?
Walking the God, mixing it up live from the barbershop. WKIP, where knowledge is power and knowledge is free.
Thank you. Black women are under such attack in America and the Western world because the Europeans understand very clearly that your God having a human experience, but you don't understand that clearly. You think God got to be set up in the sky, knowing Dr. Bain is the heaven between a black woman's leg, people thought that was an offensive thing. No, you find me a black man that would rather go anywhere else. Knowing Dr. Ben was the heaven between a black woman's leg, people thought that was an offensive thing. No. You find me a black man that would rather go anywhere else. I, God, expanded in you, meaning I create myself out of myself. And I, God, expanded in you, meaning you are me. When I realize myself to be in existence, I look and beside me stood the woman, who is the ultimate God of creation. I come from a woman, that a woman is God, that I come from a woman, that a woman is God, and out of her arise what we call God. One of the reasons why black women are under such attack in American and Western world, because the European understands very clearly that you are God having a human experience, but you don't understand that clearly, because you think God got to be some spooky shit up in the sky somewhere. You know, God, they can be no God without you. And I, God, expanded in you, meaning you are me. I, God, expanded in you. I create myself out of myself. And I, God, expanded in you, meaning you are me. When I realize myself to be in existence, I look and beside me stood the woman, who is the ultimate God of creation. I come from a woman, that a woman is God. I come from a woman, that a woman is God. And out of her arise what we call God. One of the reasons why black women are under such attack in America and the Western world, because the European understands very clearly that you are God having a human experience, but you don't understand that clearly, because you think God got to be some spooky shit up in the sky somewhere. You know, they can be no God without you. And God is every and all things at once. It means God occupies all space and time. So everything that exists is an expression of an access of that divinity. There's nothing in existence that has a greater power than the first manifestation as a human being, which is the black woman. The black woman is the first manifestation as a human being, and you manifest out of God's essence itself. You know, when Dr. Ben was the heaven between a black woman's leg, people thought that was an offensive thing. No. You find me a black man that would rather go anywhere else. Knowing Dr. Ben was the heaven between a black woman's leg, people thought that was an offensive thing. No. You find me a black man that would rather go anywhere else. You find me a living being, other than a few little chemical things that play tricks with lately, where light don't come out of the belly of that black woman. Because people have abused you, because you're teaching. They're not scared of your body. Y'all got some fine bodies, I'm gonna tell you that right straight up front. But I'm a brother who appreciates black women. But they're afraid of your mind. God expanded in you. I create myself out of myself.
You think God got to be some spooky shit up in the sky somewhere?
Who is the ultimate God of creation? I come from a woman. That woman is God. I come from a woman. That a woman is God.
You think God got to be some spooky shit up in
the sky? I, God, expanded in you. I create myself out of myself. And I, God,
sit up in the sky somewhere. You know?
Don't strengthen your weaknesses, strengthen your strength. I've got some news for you. There is a mind in you that never forgets anything.
Don't you ever forget.
Recognize the God mind in you, and you will energize it in you and as you. Look how old God is. God hasn't forgotten a thing.
Oh, don't you ever forget.
All right. God has never made a mistake. God has never been sick a day in his life. As a man thinks, so is he. What you recognize, you energize. As a man thinks, so is he. What you recognize, you energize. Remember that. That's the law. What we ought to do right now is to recognize that within our being we do have strength and courage.
Don't you ever forget.
What I recognize, I energize. Together, what I recognize, I energize. What you recognize, you energize. Remember that. That's the law. As a man thinks, so is he.
Don't you ever forget that.
As a man thinks, so is he. What you recognize, you energize. Remember that. That's the law. What you recognize within yourself, you will energize. If you recognize your weakness, you'll even give power to your weakness. My goodness. If you recognize your faults and your failures, you will energize your faults and your failures. As a man thinks, so is he. As a man thinks, so is he. What you recognize, you energize. Remember that. That's the law. How many of you have ever jokingly said, "Oh, I'm so dumb"? Come on, let's have confession. I don't care how stupid you are. Stop recognizing your stupidity and start recognizing your divine intelligence. Stop recognizing your failures, because you are giving power and energy to your failures. Whenever your so-called weaknesses and mistakes and forgetfulness and stupidity begin to rise up before you, shout them down with the word of God. I think many times religion has taught us to emphasize the negative. I like that old song that says, you've got to, what? Accentuate the positive. Eliminate the negative. Whenever you talk about the devil, always do it in a de-energizing way. Be sure that it's in a discrediting way. Whenever you talk about the devil, be sure that you call him a liar. Because what you recognize, you energize. Now, don't you ever forget that. What you recognize within yourself, you will energize. As a man thinks, so is he. Accentuate the positive. Eliminate. As a man thinks, latch on to the affirmative and don't mess with Mr. In Between Banks. Remember that. That's the law. Don't you ever forget that.
Walkie the God, mixing it up live from the barbershop. WKIP, where knowledge is power and knowledge is free.
America is no good at all. What the American people want is simple. They want an America as good as its promised. Well, America is no good at all.
America. Someone had to take care of them 24 hours a day. And it'd be pretty hard, you know. as far as colored people are concerned, I feel that they were considered happier than they are now. They had less in the way of material things. But I can remember back in the 20s and I was a small boy, they were always singing at their work.
It's because of white racist cops. White racist cops. Before I get into this, though, I just want to say this. If I make a mistake and I get this information that might not be correct, I can be corrected. I can live with that. But one thing I know for sure it is there are a lot of black people in this country who think these incidents are just isolated. They don't feel like it's out in the community. Oh, that was just that bad. You know what I mean?
Right.
But truth is, it's some type of cleansing going on. This is preliminary stages. When a Caucasian racist cop pulls you over, if he murders you, there is nothing for you in the system. They're going to walk in through. So, I'm here to let you know. Every day, when you get in your car, when you go somewhere, you are in danger. And on top of that, there is nothing your family can do. The police can shoot you dead, and nothing will happen to you except you go home. We all saw a woman on Facebook. Everything that's happening in this country, you might think that it's something that's going to go away eventually. It's not going to go away. It's going to get worse. We have to train our people to snap out of all the bullshit that they've been taught. Whatever it is that's been said to you in a fucking classroom, none of that shit, nothing. Your life is in danger. The second you step a toe out that apartment, your life is in danger in your apartment as well, because they have written laws to walk in your, they don't have to have a warrant. They can bust in your front door, shoot your black ass, and nothing will, they will be walking through the system. It's almost like paperwork. And after a while, they're not going to have paperwork anymore. It's just going to be like, that's the key. If he shot you, you did something wrong. I got a cousin who a cop. I love my cousin, but I'll tell him, man, them motherfuckers, I don't know what the fuck you think you doing. If you ain't out there shooting unarmed black people, you with the motherfuckers who do it.
Who are? There it is.
What they had, all you motherfuckers who don't do that, y'all stand around and watch the people and they sitting there looking shocked. Did they kill Leroy? Leroy ain't do nothing. Your ass standing over there, step back. Step, you with them, motherfucker.
And so, just like we give you.
Said the other day, if you get into a fight with another black man, y'all more than likely go battle.
Yes,
no, all that black on black crime shit. Y'all at each other. But when a cop comes, you submit. You give him the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah.
And while you're sitting there, unarmed, or you ain't got your gun out, if you get into it with somebody else, you got your gun out of y'all.
Right.
But a cop, you ain't pull your gun out. And they kill you for having it.
Waffity God, Free Knowledge Radio, WKIP, where knowledge is power and knowledge is free. Gotta get you some money.
All cops who don't fight the racist white motherfuckers in uniform, protect us against them, you're on his side. You just ain't quick to shoot motherfuckers like that. Right, you just not gonna tell that motherfucker. Up to people unarmed and shoot them,
right.
But you with that motherfucker who do, and you not like them officers in New York.
racist white motherfuckers who shoot innocent black people. I'm here to tell you, we have to murder these motherfuckers. I say this to all my brothers and sisters in the military. You know it's wrong. You over there fucking with people that ain't never done shit to you. Get the fuck out of that bullshit. Come home and get ready to protect your mama, your daddy, your sisters, your brother. Because them same motherfuckers giving you orders and taking for granted that you ain't got the guts to walk away from that shit and come protect your people over here.
I'm here to tell you. necessity of ventilating.
I question America. Is this America, the land of the free and the home of the brave, where we have to speak with our telephones off of the hook because our lives be threatened daily because we want to live as decent human beings in America?
I grew up in Washington, D.C., later named Chocolate City. And the experience of growing up in Washington, D.C., in Southeast Washington, which is right on the Maryland, D.C. border, with poor white people on the Maryland border, and working black folks on the D.C. side was pretty crucial in laying the foundation for my understanding of humanity, not just of race. As a child, as my children are, I was really inquisitive. And so I knew that when I went to Northwest Washington, D.C., where the Capitol, the Monument, and the White House were located, that there was a different quality of life than people who matriculated that area. And then right down the street almost, on T Street in Northwest, where my grandmother and grandfather lived, it was not that way. I mean, they had their own home, but directly opposite the street they were on, people lived in abject poverty. And in the wintertime, as I got older, I was sad and horrified to think about what people did in the cold winter if they didn't have heat, and many of them didn't. Said to me simply, sugar, white folks have set it up like this. White folks have set it up like this. And I'm thinking about the white children and the white families I knew. They were too poor to set anything up. And I asked her, because they were in the same situation I felt that we were in. And they really are. Against the Jewish people. that this had gone on for centuries, not just a period of time leading to a war, and that the government has sanctioned it. And that the government has sanctioned it, that the Pope at the time had sanctioned it. I became angry.
Anybody's religion, but think about it, they took everything from us. way you must live. If black folks never stand up, they're gonna blow this bitch up. They're so fucking parasitic. They always want more. It's never fucking enough. And what I realized from a spiritual standpoint, and I just say this, like, religion hadn't worked for black folks. I told the Christian dude this, and he couldn't even argue with me. I was like, bro, tell me when any of this shit has ever worked for us. For the last 500 years, and the only reason why you say you're blessed is because you don't know what you were before. If you knew that you created math and science and purity and this shit, there's no way that you would mumble that you were blessed now. You're a fucking slave. I'm a fucking slave, dude.
Black power shit. Black power shit.
We are a reflection of the surroundings that are around us. Now, one or two people will get out, and they'll use that person as the flagship person, but he's one out of fucking 45,000 people. Even ghettos before the Nazis used that against Jewish people, and they know from a science perspective, and you take animals and put a whole bunch of animals in a constricted area with limited resources, they're going to tear each other apart. That's what the fucking term ghetto means. So when white people say black folks live in the ghetto, that means you know what you fucking did. And no way am I taking shots at anybody's religion. These racists been here. Like you see all of these fucking crackheads.